Hey, welcome back to Coding at Home. Today we are gonna play a game called Right and Left, which is both a competitive and a collaborative game. And that's why I'm not alone, but I am together with Anna today.
Hi.
Okay, so as you can see, we are gonna use the same equipment that we used yesterday, which means that we have a chequered board, a 5x5 board, that can be also drawn with a marker on a white paper if you don't want to print it out as I did yesterday. And then we also have tiles with footprints. This is the sheet of paper that I printed out from which I cut some of them yesterday. You can also make your own from scratch without printing them from the internet. But what's very important is that we have three types of tiles: the yellow ones, the gray ones, and the red ones. And those tiles are like an instruction set, because if we have a robot, a small robot like this one, the yellow tiles represent a turn left instruction. The gray one represents a go straight instruction, and the red one a turn right instruction, okay? And we are going to use these instructions to make a path from a starting point to a destination. I place the starting point outside the checkered board today in order to have more room for our moves. And then I place the ending position here. And the two players, or the two teams, are placing their tiles in turn. And it's a collaborative game in the sense that we are collaborating in creating a path from the starting point to the destination. But at the same time, we are competing because I'm the yellow team and I'm trying to put along the path as many left turns as possible, yellow tiles, while Anna is the red team trying to place as many red tiles as possible. So, Anna, do you want to start?
Yes.
Oh. Counterintuitive move from Anna. And I introduce a new rule just to contrast the move from Anna, which is the fact that I'm not necessarily placing my tile here right after the one that Anna has just placed, but I can also place it here, for instance, so that we will have two segments of the path, and then we have to try to join them. So if we take a snapshot, I'm winning this time. Okay, yet another rule. I can place my tile wherever I want in the checkered board, or better, in any empty box. So, for instance, I can place it, let me see, I could place it here. Okay. Okay. Oh, no, bad move. Why is it a bad move? Oh, no,
this
is not a bad move.
Yours
this
was.
This is a smart move, sorry. Why I thought it was a bad move? Because I thought that those two tiles had to be included in the path. Well, this is not true, because there is a way of cutting them off, and that's the decision that Anna took. So right now we found a path which goes from the starting point to the destination in this way, you see. And basically, if we take our robot and we see if the instructions placed along the path work, this is a turn left, turn right, go straight, turn right, turn left, destination. So this means that these two tiles were not used, and they have not to be counted in order to see if I won the game. And since there are two red tiles and two yellow tiles, this is a draw. Okay? So I have a question for you. Is it possible with this disposition of the starting and ending positions to have a winner in this game? Think about it. While we are playing another match with a different setting, like this one. Okay, Anna, do you want to start?
Yes.
Okay. So let me see. This is a good move. And I can try to contrast it. Okay. Okay. Okay, let me go. Well done. Okay, I'm afraid that this time I have no choice but to facilitate what Anna had in mind since the very beginning. I could add more turns and make the path a little bit more complicated, but at the end she will win this game. Because as you can see, there are four red tiles and just two yellow tiles. So with this disposition, for sure, there is a winner. There could be a winner. And my question is different right now. Is with this disposition, is it possible to have a draw? I have even another question, which is, are there dispositions on the checkered board of the starting and ending positions that go in favor of one of the two teams? So in your opinion, Anna, is there any initial setting?
Yes, because if I turn the ending point towards the left or the right, the other, let's say that the other team is gonna win, because we need at least one turn to that direction.
Okay.
So, for example, in this
way... Okay, so for instance, if we place it here, which makes it much easier to understand...
Yes.
Who is the winner in this case?
The yellow ones.
The yellow
one. Winner.
Yeah. While if I place it here...
Same thing, because...
Okay, but do you think that you... could win a game as a red team starting with this setting?
Yes, I could.
Wow.
Because...
Okay, let's try.
Okay. So if I start with the left.
Okay, why?
Because starting this way, I could walk around the ending position.
Great.
And so I would have to turn right many times.
That's great. I appreciate. So by placing my tile at the very beginning, she is probably gonna win the game. But we won't play this match because we leave this question open for you. And I'm also asking you if given a disposition of starting and ending positions, is it possible to predict which will be the game between the winning and losing team? So leaving all these questions open for you, We say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.